All right, we're here with Columbus's dynamic duo of the backfield, Lorenzo Woodley, Daryl Chestnut. Guys, last year, you guys made it farther than any team at Columbus had in almost 30 years. I know the goal this year is to take that one last step, you know, make it a game further and win it. I guess talk a little bit about just looking at last year, how fun that was, and, you know, to make some history for the school, and, you know, what you guys have a chance together to do something special this year.
We were taught in that offseason last year, and you know, we strive, you know, every game after game to make it to that point in the playoffs, and unfortunately we made it further than the school has ever made it in history. So that was a big accomplishment for us last year, but now the goal for this year is to make it one step ahead, and that's to the state championship, and not just to make it, to win it as well.
You got a pretty complete team last year. What do you think was missing right there at the end when you guys were got beat by Miramar?
You know, we didn't finish. We came up strong. We fought, but we just didn't finish. We finished this year. We'll be better.
What I guess talking about that, like, what regret did you have after the game? Maybe something you saw later when you guys went back and saw the game. Maybe something you could have done differently.
I had no regrets due to the fact that we played as one unit. We played as a team. We played as a whole. We gave it all we had. Miramar was a better team at that point. But, you know, we just trying to work hard this off season to make it better next season.
Well, why can't this Columbus team better last year and become a state champion this year? Why do you feel that's happening?
Because I feel that if we're good enough to make it to the regional finals, we're good enough to make it to the state finals, which is only one game away. So without a doubt, I don't have a doubt in my mind that we can make it to the state championship.
Now last year, I know one thing was a crowded backfield because it was you guys, and you had Brandon Radcliffe too, and carries had to be split here and there to make sure they could utilize all three of you. But now the two of you back there, there's probably going to be more carries to dish out to both of you, I'm assuming. Can you talk a little about how it's a little different this year?
Well, we grew up playing Pop Warner football together, and we grew up sharing carries with each other. So, without in my mind, we don't have time. We don't have a problem sharing the load together. Oh.
Yeah. Talk a little bit about that. I mean, you guys grew up together. I mean, when did you guys meet?
I started playing football later. I was like, I want to say I was 8 or 9. And Lorenzo was running back to compete with him at Coconut Grove. Mm-hmm. So we started having that bond. His dad he's a great dad. He's like my dad too. He taught me how to play running back when I first came out there. Me and Lorenzo had a bond ever since that day.
Your dad played football like collegially or professionally?
Yeah, he played football at the University of Pittsburgh.
Okay. What was his name?
Lorenzo Woodley.
Lorenzo Woodley Sr.?
Junior.
Junior, okay.
Yeah.
You're there. Okay. We'll talk a little bit about then when you guys met. Were you on the same team right away when you were kids?
You know, I played offensive lineman at first.
So you were all blocking.
Yeah, I was pulling for him. Okay. I played offensive lineman, tight end, and then defense. And I was pulling for him. I was blocking for him. I was doing everything for him until one day we played against Liberty City, mm-hmm. and I finally got my opportunity to show what I could do, and I showcased my skills and. Me and him just had a bond. It came out of nowhere. Him and Amari Cooper, it just came out of nowhere.
Okay, so you guys all played on the same?
Yeah, it just came out of nowhere.
That must have been a great backfield and a very great team overall. Yeah. But who noticed your speed? Because you said that game kind of like, you know, brought that talent out to show what you do now.
Who noticed my speed first had to be my uncle. Both of my uncles, I played for my uncle when I was young. It wasn't organized, but I played for him. Like, we just go in the backyard, throw the football around. And then I went to a daycare called the Barnyard. My other uncle, he was the counselor, and he taught me how to run the ball as well, too. So they all noticed my speed.
Okay. And for you growing up, when did you sort of start to become the player you are today, Lorenzo?
Well, when I was 6 years old, I wasn't playing football yet. But my dad, you know, he was taking me in the backyard, you know, teaching me running back drills, you know, doing workouts for me, and I didn't want to do it because, you know, it was too hot, and I was, you know, crying, you know, I didn't want to do it, but, you know, he made me do it, you know, and it worked out. He taught me how to run the ball. He taught me how to be a running back. So, you know, when I turned 7, that's when I started playing for Coconut Grove Optimist team, and, you know, I did pretty good. You know, I wasn't starting. It was two other running backs. Mm-hmm. Just like I was last year, but you know, I did pretty good for my first year, and I think he taught me well all the way up to this point, and he's still teaching me mm-hmm. today, so that's a good thing.
Did you also that whole experience kind of like you said, teach you kind of like the part of, not the skill of the game, but like the hard work it takes to break through and kind of, you know, make your own mark kind of thing, you know, at that point?
Yeah, it did, because, you know, if you know, you got to work hard everywhere you go. So, you know, even in college, no matter how good you is, so, you know, what he teach me is to never stop working, no matter how good I'm doing, just to keep working to stay on the top.
So you guys call yourself Thunder and Lightning because you bring the speed and you bring the power. Yeah. You're pretty fast too, though. I've seen you running. It's not like you're slow. Let's make that clear. But I guess talk a little bit about the offense this year. I hear you guys have a new quarterback. You know, it's got some good potential. He hasn't played yet in Miami, but there's a buzz about him having a big arm. You know, can you tell us a little bit about
him? Yeah, that's true. He's only 15. Right. He's about 6'2", 230 pounds, but he has an arm. We have some threats. We obviously have Jesus Wilson, who lines up in the slot. We have another running back, Austin Armstrong. We have a lot of people that I feel like it's going to be key to our offense this year. And our quarterback is one of them.
How's the O-line looking? I know O-line, the size you got to be.
It always looks, you know, we work hard. It always looks great. It always looks great. They work hard day in and day out. They're hungry, and they're willing to work.
So how's your college situation going right now as far as, like, you know, how'd the summer go, you know, any?
This summer, I've been going to a lot of schools. We went to South Carolina, Florida State. We even checked out Penn State with all the mess they're going through. But, you know, I've seen everything. I like a lot of schools such as Florida State, Texas Tech, Kansas State, and many more, FIU as well, too. Mm-hmm. So, I'm just enjoying
life. And you, Lorenzo, what have you got looking right now for colleges and whatnot?
I attended several camps throughout this summer. I've been to Ole Miss, Alabama, Memphis, South Carolina, FSU. But right now, I'm just, you know, I'm still enjoying the recruiting process. Mm-hmm. You know, trying to, you know, see which places I like, and trying to find the best place for me to go and be happy and not, you know, think about, you know, changing my mind and making any decommitment. So, you know, wherever I go, I want it to be the place where I want to stay.
You guys mentioned Penn State, and I was just wanted to ask you guys, as athletes that are being highly recruited by different colleges, right now you're hearing, you know, coaches always telling you this and that, why to go to their school, what's great about it, and you're hearing everything sounds great. As athletes, what's the process, I guess, mentally for you guys to tell who's actually being honest with you, who's giving you the actual right opportunity for you, and what's the best fit for it? Like, what do you guys think of?
I think it's like your own personal, like, image towards yourself. You go to a school that you have the best opportunity at, that the school that you could play first at, because at the end of the day, every coach, he's going to eventually lie to you. Like, that's how I take it. Like, I'm just like, I think I could do better at the school that gives me opportunity first.
Well, it's kind of two-sided, because you know, a player in college who works hard all off season, you know, getting up at 5:30 in the morning to go work out, running, all the sweating and competing for jobs, I would assume that, you know, after all that hard work, they would want to play in the postseason or play in the bowl game. So that's why, you know, I really don't blame kids for decommitting and, you know, deciding to go to another school because of that situation. And I think they have the right to, you know, do what they want to do as far as staying to the school and decommitting from the school. So, you know, I really can't say that they're wrong for that, because that's really a tough situation, you know, especially when you're not at the school yet, you still got time, you know, to change your mind. So, you know, that's not really a bad option.
What's your frame of mind right now? Like, are you guys, as far as, like, when you might decide where you want to go, like, how are you handling that part of it?
I'm taking it one day at a time, being very patient, because this is something for my future and my life. It's going to benefit me in the future, so I'm just being extra patient.
It's easy to kind of get caught up, though, in, like, all that hype with all these websites out there. And
I don't want to rush into it because, you know, when you rush into it, that's how you make a mistake, and, you know, you decide, oh, I really don't want to go to this school. Then you look bad because you got to tell the coach, oh, I want to think about, you know, decommitting, and, you know, I want to explore the options because you decided too quick. So that's the mistake I don't want to make.
Right. You see guys around you, like friends that you maybe grew up with that are in similar situations, and then you've probably seen that they get caught up in, like, I want to commit so I can get some headlines and I can be the star and all that. But it's like, then like a month later, oh, I don't like this school anymore, you know, that type of thing. So, I mean, you kind of like have that, you guys seem to have that mentality, like you really want to make the right choice you, not just, you know, for football, for school, everything. Right. Do you talk to some, have anybody that you talk to, maybe like to tell them, you know, hey, think about this, because this is like, this is going to affect the rest of your life.
Eventually, guys talked to me, like Amari Cooper, when he committed to Alabama, he told me, when you commit, like, make it solid. Do not be able to decommit and stuff like that. He told me to be loyal to one school because they'll be loyal back to you. So I took heed in that.
Yeah. You know, he also told me, you know, go somewhere where you got the best opportunity at. You know, don't make a mistake and go to a school where, you know, you're not going to feel happy at, because you're not going to, you know, do your best there. So that's the best advice I got. But my dad, he's been helping me with my whole recruiting process. Mm. So that's who's been, you know, I've been getting advice from and everything. So that's who's been with me.
What are you guys looking at as far as maybe a career that, you know, outside of football, if anything like that, you're going to pursue? Have you guys decided on anything yet?
Or? I'll be a business/drama type guy.
Okay.
I already made my mind up. I want to study communications in college. So, you know, just in case football don't work out, because, you know, football isn't promised, anything can happen, God forbid. But, you know, have to, you know, how the guys play football, you know, how they go work for, you know, broadcasting news, you know, sports like that. That's what I want to do, because, you know, I think that's a strength in me. I believe I can handle that.
So one way or the other, I might see you on ESPN one day. If not playing, maybe in the booth, right? Okay. And you said drama because you're into like with theater, that type of thing.
No, but I feel like I can be a great actor.
Okay.
Like, I watch a lot of movies. I take guys' roles.
Okay. So same thing. If I don't see you on ESPN, I'll see you like in a movie theater. Cinema. There you go. Okay. Anything else, guys? Just, I guess, you know, looking at this year coming up, if you guys, what do you think, you know, always kind of throw that question out there, you know, where do you see this team come December? Obviously, you want to be in Orlando holding the trophy, but, I mean, any other personal goals, anything that would make this a perfect season for everybody?
My motto for every season is to do better than you did before, and for me, doing better than what I did before is winning the state championship. That's what I want to do.
I just say be humble with everything we do. Never get too cocky, and always be confident. And that's my motto, just be confident.
Thanks, gentlemen. Appreciate it.
Thank you.